Discuss the construction and types of radiators. We know that radiators provide large surface area to the heated water for increasing the rate of heat transfer and cooling it down rapidly. The front view of a typical radiator is. Now let's discuss the construction of a radiator. It mainly consists of upper or header tank, which collects hot water and passes it to the radiator tubes. Filters are attached to this tank for removing the dirt particles from entering into the radiator tubes. Lower tank, which collects cool water from the radiator tubes and sends it to the water pump. Radiator core, which is a setup of tubular pipes and fins that provides large surface area to the heated water and cools it down rapidly. Many different types of radiator cores are in use these days. However, cellular and tubular are the two main types. Cellular radiator core is a honeycomb block consisting of several hexagonal cells made up of tubes. These hexagonal cells are packed and bound together by soldering. The heated water flows through the passage between the circular parts of the tube, and the cooling air flows through the circular tubes, thus cooling down the water. This type of radiator is now obsolete because of its less efficiency. In tubular radiator cores, hot water falls down through the elliptical or circular brass tubes, and air is passed through the fins that are provided on the tubes. It has a strong structure and low initial cost. Nowadays, an improved version of tubular radiator core, known as corrugated tubular radiator core, is in use. Here, the fins are placed in a zigzag manner to increase its structural strength and provide turbulence to the air passing through it. This increases the rate of heat transfer and helps cooling water rapidly. Now let's summarize the types of radiators.